Magnetic door contacts consist of a magnet and the reed switch. I will now give you a close-up of how these are wired and how they work.
Normally, the magnet would be fixed to the door and the reed switch would be fixed to the door frame. And they would be in that kind of position, although there would be a slight gap when they were on the door. If you look at the reed switch, you can see that there are two silver terminals with a wire coming off. They are the terminals that are actually going to the reed switch. So we're going to place that down, and here we have a continuity tester. It's actually a voltage tester, this, but you can use it for continuity as well. So if we press the button, you can see that there's no continuity there at all. If we press it and touch the probes, we get continuity. If I place the reed switch directly up above the magnet and put the probes onto the reed switch, you can see that it makes the circuit. I'll now keep that pressed on there and I'll slowly move the reed switch back. So you can see that you can move it a considerable distance before the actual magnet stops pulling in the reed switch. So we've got a good inch there. If we move that back in now, you can see that it is working again. So the magnet opens and closes the reed switch, which opens and closes the circuit. I'm now going to strip off the tampers, which is the yellow and the green, and I'm going to twist those two wires together. And then I'm just going to place that in there, and I'm going to get the correct length for the white and the blue. So we need a bit cutting off the blue. So we're going to bend the conductor around, and we're going to hook it around that screw. That will then form the tamper loop. And now we're going to connect up the alarm wire, so we're going to remove this screw and the washer. We're just going to twist the conductors around. And then we're going to make a loop on that side of the washer. And then when this screw is tightened up, the washer will clamp down onto the actual conductor. And then we're going to repeat that process for the terminal at that side, which will be the blue wire. This is a bit of a fiddly job. Once they are tight, that is it. The door contact can now be placed on the door.
And we can now screw the door contact in position. We can now put the magnet in position. It doesn't actually need to be touching. We can have a millimetre or so of a gap. So we can now drill the door. So that is the door contact fitted. We now need to wire that up in the panel. We're going to wire that to zone one. We're now going to wire up the magnetic door contact. So I have fed the cable into the back of the alarm box there, and I've run it down the back of the printed circuit board. If you remember, we used blue and white for the circuit wires, so they will be terminated into terminals one, and then the green and the yellow will be used for the tamper. It may look like there's a lot of room down here for your wires. There isn't. Later on, we need to put the battery in there. That will take up all of that spare room. So we're now going to terminate the white and the blue to zone one. As with all the other wires, I have stripped it, twisted the strands together, and then bent it back on itself. So we've now put them in zone number one, and that is the entry and exit zone. Just check they're tight. So now that zone is wired up, we can forget about that. We now need to wire the green and yellow into the tamper. And the tamper is that terminal there. So we're just going to remove the link. If you only had the one sensor on the alarm, you would simply put those two wires into the tamper. that is a closed loop. Because we're adding another sensor, or if you're adding multiple sensors, you need to wire these up so that it makes one continuous loop. So you wire them up in series. That way, if any of the wires are cut, the alarm will go into a tamper. If you wired all these wires into the in parallel, you could cut through one set of the wires and it wouldn't alarm. So that's why you have to wire all the tamper wires up in series. But just for now, we'll just place those two wires into the tamper terminals. Although when we come to wire the next sensor up, we will have to remove one of the wires. So that's how to wire up a magnetic door contact.